Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is ATB and welcome back to another Castle Clash video. So today we're gonna be doing some more guild wars, but today we're gonna be using something that might be surprising for most of you. We're gonna be using Lil Nick, and you know, I'm gonna explain you guys why we are using Lil Nick. So we're gonna be using Lil Nick, Wovanka, Triantar, Wazulix, Dreadrake, Ronin, and yeah, that's it. We're facing off against Grease, Grinding Pirates, Grinding Pirates, Shadow of Doom, and Dragon Slayer. So top 5 is gonna be top 4 from Grease and top Shadow of Doom. The reason why we've hit top Grease is because he hit no heroes at server reset, and yeah, as you guys can see, this is when we got him. So, okay, let me go ahead and check all the pets. Okay, this is fine. Okay, so let's just go ahead and see if we can get top 5 done without dropping any flame. Honestly, I'm pretty confident that we can do this without dropping a flame, but you know, it's gonna be way, way harder than it used to be. Wow, I definitely need higher breakthrough on Ronin, because as you guys saw, he just got one shot by a wow proc, which, no, it's not supposed to happen. Now, we're gonna have quite a few troops left. Hopefully Ronin hopefully Ronin clears them, or we're gonna have to use Wazulix on the top. Boys, what should we do? Let's just go ahead and do that, and we got them cleared. I think honestly that was pretty lame, Wazulix drop. But we had to take care of the troops. And as you guys can see, Doombaloon is doing quite good job. With Wovanka? Okay, so now let's see what Lil Nick does. He actually did something. Okay, so we're just gonna revive the heroes and get those runes done as fast as possible, because it is currently almost midnight. And I have to wake up for school at like 6 a.m. So yeah, gonna have to actually upload the video probably before bed. We'll see, depends on when I'm done recording and if editing takes too long. But yeah, this video is definitely gonna be up by tomorrow morning, I would say. I don't know, man, but yeah. Man, are you serious? Hopefully, that base is pretty tough, to be honest with you. And those troops on the middle are... gonna be an issue, I would say. Yeah, dude, those troops on the middle are gonna be an issue. That is for sure, boys. That is for sure. But actually, I don't think we're gonna have any... Oh! Okay, I mean... No issues, boys, no issues, which is quite nice. So, next up... Okay, how long did it take us to get those two bases done? 3 minutes? That's acceptable. 601... Toad agrees. Let's just go ahead and drop Ronin on the bottom, and then we're gonna probably drop Wazulix on the top. We will see, but yeah. Too bad we let that creation one pro canal on our Ronin. Now we're gonna have to actually be careful with the troops. Man, Ronin, get those parts. Get Get those buildings destroyed, man. We need you. We need you, Ronin. We need you, my man. We need you. We need you on the middle now. Nah. 2-0, 2-0, boys. 2-0% to continue that. I was kinda hoping we would hit those buildings on the middle because, you know, they are healthy. Like 600, 700,000 HP buildings. So, oh no, Ronin, stay down, stay there, Ronin. Good job, Ronin. Okay, I mean, we pretty much got what we wanted, right? Now, I think we need a good Phoenix proc, or a good Wazulix proc would be nice. Like right here, 51%. Okay, 64 is better than 51, I believe it was. But yeah, we're gonna have all those buildings destroyed by Lavanica, I am sure. So let's go ahead and move those doves on the bottom. Well, didn't work out as planned, but we should be fine, boys. We should be fine. How much damage that Doomba wound did, man? Like, what? Okay, that's 81,000. And now I'm just gonna go ahead and drop those before the Doomba wound extra damage expired. Okay, that's good. That's good. And by the way, guys, I just wanna check how much is the extra damage. Okay, so deal 600 bad attack damage to a maximum of 5 nearby enemy buildings every 6 seconds. So also increases the damage they take by 26% for 3 seconds. Yeah, 26% it is pretty good. So last but not least, we have Shadow of Doom top. And it is someone that I have no idea how to pronounce his name. Like, literally no idea how to pronounce this name. Manu? Manu? What? Absolutely no idea what that is. Absolutely no idea, boys. But yeah, man, I think Ronin, Wazulix, and Wava is actually doing pretty damn good. Like, you can take out this whole side with Ronin, then you take out this with Wazulix, and then you take out the bottom with Lavanica. Now, man, it's only 23%, but nah, I'm actually gonna actually do it because I don't wanna risk. I want at least 30. Way too risky. Is 23 is just way too risky. So yeah, excuse me, boys. I'm not trying for, you know, I'm not trying to first try those bases because I don't wanna lose flames. We don't have black skies in this Guild Wars, but I still don't want to lose flames because, you know, the better Guild Wars streak, just I would say the better motivation, but nah. Okay, 35%, so yeah. Wazulix is gonna get all that destroyed, hopefully. Oh man, Wazulix almost didn't get a proc off. That was crazy, but thankfully Wazulix got that proc off. Now, where are we? Where are we gonna drop Ovanka right here? And hopefully this tower doesn't have like full HP, and it does. So I'm gonna have to drop Dreadrake right after Doombaum procs next time. Okay, we got it. We took advantage of that 26% extra damage. So yeah, Guild Wars done in 8 minutes. It's only 4 bases, so 10 minutes, 2 minutes per base, but yeah, 66,700. What? 66,700? Well, I mean, 6,671 points. Not that bad. So now let's go ahead and show you guys what we used. We used Wovanikov's 9 Secret White, Doom Balloon, Revive, Forest Ward, and Dodge. Next up was Ulix with 9 Revive, Yulefant, 8 Revive, Forest Ward, and pretty much all Dodge. Now, Dreadrix, 9 Revive with Punching Box, 8 Unholy Pact, 5-5 Victory Lunge, and pretty much all Dodge, which we should change to Damage. Now, Ronin with 9 Revive, Phoenix, 8 Survival, Forest Ward, and HP. Lil Nick with 8 Revive, which we should make 9 Revive. What was that? Mini Angie, 8 Unholy Pact, Fury, which we should change to a damage enchantment, and random traits, which we should also change to damage. And now 3, all that matters is Revive and Revive, but we have Forest Ward and pretty random traits. But as you guys can see, we have a lot of room for improvement. The least is Breakthrough. But yeah, we definitely need to get some breakthrough done sooner than later. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, please make sure you leave a like and subscribe. That would be very appreciated. But yeah, that's gonna be pretty much it for this video. I hope you all did enjoy it, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.